Yo guys, what is up? It is Nick. We are back on Fallout 4. We're going to be continuing here, trying to get out of Vault 111. So let's go ahead and get going. Oh yeah, you can go off to these side areas. Is there anything? Some monitoring terminal. All right. I'm not gonna read all of that stuff and go too in depth that way because I feel like at this point you've watched a comprehensive guide for this game by now, if that's what you were looking for. Pre-war money. And at this point I'm not worrying too much about collecting supplies or whatnot. That'll come later. I don't need to do that right now. Okay, wait, that's where I'm supposed to go. Where does this lead? Oh, it's inaccessible. I thought there was some items, more items than I found. Come here. Okay, take the cockroach meat just in case I need it.
Giant roaches. What the hell?
Pre-war money right here, I believe, is the terminal. This is where you get an achievement. I'll try to point these out as I find them. Play the tape. And it is Red Menace. It's kind of like a. It's like a. It's a real. I don't even remember. It's a real game, I think. But it's kind of like Donkey Kong. Has that. The, like, original Donkey Kong games. Kind of has that. That sort of design. Let's get up to the top. I'm not gonna play this for long. Okay, well, let's go ahead and quit the game. And let me eject it so we can take it. And let's continue. Don't need to sit there and play that, even though I could sit there and play that for a while, because it's actually kind of fun. I don't know why games within games are so much fun. If I had that like on my iPhone, I'd be like, eh, whatever. But since it's on as like a game within a game, it gains a whole new appeal. Why am I not punching? Okay, that was weird. Where did that? Oh, here it goes. I want the rad roach meat.
What happened here? Where is everyone?
Okay, no more cockroaches. I think I'm on normal difficulty, if you guys are wondering. I'm not gonna play on survival or anything. If there was an achievement for it, I might do it. If someone really wants to see it, I might do it for you guys just to show you. Oh, would you look at that? So many stim packs.
Is this all that's left?
10 milli, 10 milli pistol, Overseer's terminal, the cryolator, that's the weapon. I made a video on how to get it. We'll come back and get it. Open evacuation tunnel. Okay. Let's look around in here. Here's the cryolator right here. You have to have master lockpick. Can also, well, I'm not gonna say that. They've probably patched it by now. But in the beginning, you could use dog meat to get it. It was kind of a glitch. But I'm 99.9% sure they patched it. I would assume they patched it. Ooh. Okay, I actually have a decent chunk of ammo to start out with. It's been a while since I started this game from the beginning, because I've only done it once. So I don't actually remember everything there is to remember. Bobby pin, pre-war money. Can I turn on my flashlight? No. Do I not have a pip? Oh, and I don't have a Pip-Boy yet. I forgot. You don't start with it. Whoa! There's a lot more rad roaches here than I remember. And I can't aim, and hipfire is Magunda. Look at that. he dead? No, he's not dead. The hip fire on this gun is horrible. It's ridiculous. I need a steady aim perk so I can hip fire. Because this game... Like, I love this game, but the first person aspect to it, there is some clunkiness to it. It's not the most smooth first person shooter ever. Okay. Okay, there's the Pip-Boy. Oh. It's a rad roach. Okay, I want to look around here real quick before we head out. Let me check. Okay, this is really dark. I think there's some stuff down here. Or there's something. Is there? I thought there was like one thing down here. The lunchbox? I thought there was like a lunchbox down here. Maybe not. Alright, let's head back here, check this area out, and then we'll get out of here. Nothing in the toolbox. Oh, is this? This is where we came from. Okay. Turn back around. That's where I came from. Alright, let's go ahead and pick up this Pip-Boy. I wonder how many people got stuck here for, like, because it doesn't tell you to pick the Pip-Boy up, does it? Those are the specs initiating. Alright, I know how to change the tabs. Let me go ahead... Favorite. Okay, it's already favorited. Okay, we're good. Let's get out of here. Okay, remote access to the door.
If the door cycling sequence initiated, please stand back.
If the audio for the guns and stuff is a little loud, I will have it fixed for next episode. Some of the stuff that I had settings-wise got reset from when I was making my videos showing tutorials, so there is some audio that I don't know if it's gonna sound good or not, so bear with me for the first couple episodes here, and then it'll be good for the long haul. If this was gonna be a shorter series, obviously I'd make sure it was perfect from the beginning, but it's nice and long, so I think one or two episodes of... It's not going to be bad, audio-wise. It just might be a little bit louder than I would want it, and you would want it just a little bit, or a little bit quieter. But I think we should be alright. Alright, could this door open any slower? Alright, baby, to the circle. To the top. Special attributes. I think we're good. How does this... I want to see how this does this. Hold on. Just real quick. Where does it put us that we can edit? If it puts us back in front of that mirror. Okay. Okay, I'm done. I just wanted to see where it did that. Okay. We can exit the vault.
Enjoy your return to the surface. And thank you for choosing Vault Tech.
Yeah, okay, whatever. I haven't decided on a couple things, like what I'm gonna go with. Am I gonna focus on energy weapons, or am I gonna focus on energy weapons or regular weapons, or I'm not going melee. I suck at melee in this game. I'm not rolling melee. Or what I'm gonna go with. I'm still not quite sure. This is a really cool exit from the vault. They did a lot of great things at the beginning, and then the ending. The ending is just so lackluster compared to the beginning. So I'm just gonna hit that in case when I come back I don't have to do anything special. You could go explore here. Let me go at least explore this thing over here. do need to get some stuff here at the beginning. I can really start rolling. I probably won't do it like I could, but I could really just start rolling through this game. But I'm going to take my time, enjoy it, make it a series more than just a quick run through of the game. Now, I may play it again, probably not right after this, but I may play it again in the near future. So let's go ahead, take the weird path down the mountain. There's that bridge, still intact. That's a surprise, a wooden bridge, still intact, with no maintenance after all that time. Wow, my camera spun really fast right there. Alright, sanctuary. Let's see here, our house is right over here.
Codsworth?
As I live and breathe! Oh, it's really you!
Codsworth, you're still here. So other people could still be alive too.
Well, of course I'm still here. Surely you don't think a little radiation could deter the pride of General Atomics International. But you seem the worse for wear. Best not let the hubby see you in that state, huh? Where is Sir, by the way?
He's in a better place.
Oh, Mum, these things you're saying, these terrible things, I believe you need a distraction. Yes. A distraction to calm this dire mood. It's been ages since we've had a proper family activity. Checkers, or perhaps charades. Oh, Sean does so love that game. Is the lad with you?
Sean's been kidnapped. And I'm gonna find him. I'm gonna get my baby back.
It's worse than I thought. Mm-hmm. You're suffering from hunger-induced paranoia. Not eating properly for 200 years will do that, I'm afraid.
200 years? What? Are you sure?
A bit over 210, actually, Mum. Give or take a little for the Earth's rotation and some minor dings to the old chronometer. That means you're 2 centuries late for dinner. Perhaps I can whip you up a snack. You must be famished.
Codsworth, you're acting a little weird. What's wrong?
Mum, it's been just horrible. 2 centuries with no one to talk to, no one to serve. I spent the first 10 years trying to keep the floors waxed, but nothing gets out nuclear fallout from vinyl wood. Nothing! And don't get me started about the futility of dusting a collapsed house. And the car, the car! How do you polish rust?
Whoa, whoa. Focus, Codsworth.
I'm afraid I don't know anything, Mum. The bombs came and all of you left in such a hurry. I thought for certain you and your family were dead. I did find this holotape. I believe Sir was going to present it to you. As a surprise. But then, well, everything happened.
A holotape? What's on it?
I believe it's a private message for you. My etiquette protocols would not permit me to play it for myself. Any standard holotape reading device should be able to play it back. Oh, like that Pip-Boy on your arm. That should work brilliantly. Now, enough feeling sorry for myself. Shall we search the neighborhood together? Sir and young Sean may turn up yet.
I don't know, Codsworth.
Follow me.
Okay, we're gonna listen to the holotape first, and then we'll get into this. Hold on. We need to change this color in my HUD. It is way too hard to see. Oh, hold on. That's not what I want. Sure, I'm just gonna move these colors around until I find a color I like. Oh, hold on. Crap. I want the Pip-Boy color. Here we go. Red. Add some green. Yeah, sure. We'll roll with the blue. Is that easier to see? That's not bad. Okay. Now, what's it under? Data? Is it under inventory? Here we go.
So I know our best days are yet to come. There will be changes, sure. Things we'll need to adjust to. I'll rejoin the civilian workforce. You'll shake the dust off your law degree. But everything we do, no matter how hard we do it for our family. Now say goodbye, Sean. Bye-bye. Say bye-bye. Bye, honey.
Okay, that was really quiet. I'm not sure if you guys could even hear it. I don't know why that was so quiet. Alright, Codsworth. Alright. Oh, wait, that's actual food. I'm just taking main stuff now, stuff that I can actually use, because there's no point in lugging around a bunch of garbage. Alright, here we go. Okay, so it's this way. There we go.
Yes.
So, 38 rounds, 10 mil, a pipe pistol, pre-war money, Psycho, Radix, alright, some good stuff in there, and a gold watch. Hold on, Codsworth. A laundered green dress. I really, really wish I could move these. I think they're just candles, but I could set them up, make them look like poker chips, and I could make that area in my mansion freaking awesome. But alas, I can't move those, and you can't create them. I can't wait for the mods to come out for this, because it will add different, it'll add more stuff that I can do and build and all that different stuff. I cannot wait for mods. Cigar box. Anything else in here worthwhile? Be nice if someone else had a safe that I could pick. I don't remember if anybody else in this neighborhood has a safe. I don't want your stupid... Oh, there it is. I don't want your stupid, cutlery. Okay, next house. I think this house is just all caved in, yeah. Okay, so that's not a house I need. That's not, let's check this house. Anything good in here, Codsworth? Alright, Codsworth. I don't really care. About that, I'm looking for supplies. I'm looking for that good loot. And I can't jump that stupid barrier right there. Just a bunch of straight garbage. Clean tan suit. I will take that silver locket. Toy car, baby rattle. I still need to finish. I still haven't technically finished my giant mansion that I showed you guys. I still need to 100% complete that. But I don't know when I'm going to do that. I'll probably do it when they release mods. So my question is, okay, so you can start building here in Sanctuary before you bring the Minutemen here. So you can get rid of, not that this really helps. Well, you know what the point of this is, except you clear away the crappy houses. It just gives you a bunch of steel. Okay, I'm not gonna mess with this right now. We might do a couple of episodes of building and stuff. Maybe I'll build another awesome mansion for you guys in an episode or something. I don't know. I don't know what I'm gonna do, but I don't need to be doing this right now. I need to stop before I get over-involved in this. Okay, exit. Let's finish checking these houses, looking for some supplies, and then we will talk to Codsworth. This whole episode might be me looting different stuff. They also need to add, like, they're missing some essential stuff in character creation. I don't know how that got through. That they just kind of let it slide through, like, toilet. Like a good bathtub, a good toilet, we're missing a sink. Like, that's just ridiculous that we're missing that. We don't have a sink. We're missing a ton of the good stuff that you need. Unless there's magazines, which I don't think there are. I don't think we checked our own house. We moved on quickly from our own house. But there doesn't appear to be anything here. I'll probably set up home base just in my house here. When I start collecting items and I start having too much to carry, I probably will set up the house here. That's what I did my last playthrough. I just set up shop here and, gold-plated. But I just set up shop here before I created that huge mansion. I still haven't even technically beat the game. I beat the game with all three endings, but on that save, I actually haven't beat the game. I'm still pre-beating the game, which is pretty funny. So if anybody, like, looked at my play on my games, it doesn't look like I beat Fallout 4 yet. Nuka-Cola bottle? I don't want a bottle. I want the actual Nuka-Cola. Wow, there's just a bunch of junk. There's not anything good. I don't want your yellow fedora. You don't have a sink. I wonder what... I've gotten some decent selling items and some decent... Oh gosh, hold on. Look at that hipfire. Why is that hipfire such garbage? That hipfire is straight bukkake, but there is a Nuka Cherry in there. Yum yum deviled eggs. I don't think I've ever drank a Nuka Cherry in my whole playthrough. 4 days, almost four and a half days essentially of playing this game. I don't think I drank a Nuka Cherry. I think I hold on to every single one. Alright, here we go. Oh, we got 7 bobby pins. So I can pop this open. Does it go this way? No. Okay, so it's probably about right there. Yep.
Sweet.
Got my bobby pin pack and a casual outfit. That sounds like it's what I was wearing at the beginning of the game. I don't want to wear this vault jumpsuit, even though it's not bad looking. It's not horrible looking, but I want to get my elegant dress. Is that what it's called? No, I think it's called a sequin dress. I think that's what I want to get. That's what I wear. Because it looks good. The red dress looks kind of... It doesn't look as good. It looks kind of trashy. The sequin dress looks really nice. It's definitely my favorite. Because, you know... stupid Dark Souls got me into this whole fashion thing. Literally, with Dark Souls, it's just fashion Souls for me. I don't really care about the armor. I don't care how good the armor is. It's all about how it looks. And that's how it's translated to these games. Makeshift bomb. Ooh, a silver pocket watch. Alright, this house has some stuff worth doing. So let's go ahead and pop this open. Yeah, this episode's going to be completely just me messing around in Sanctuary. I think this is almost just no movement. Right there. There we go.
That's it.
Ooh, pre-war money. Up a wazoo and a gold watch. Nice. Okay, let's hack this terminal. Just for the experience. Alright, I know how to hack. I'm not that... I suck at hacking, but... I bet I can just do this one.
Yes.
Okay, that was really easy. Sanctuary Hills. Okay, we're not reading all that. You don't have time to listen to me read, and I ain't got time to read. Oh, wait, I almost missed that medics. How many houses do I have left? Okay, we're almost done, because that house is collapsed. We have this house, and then I think it's that house over there. That's it. Okay. Taking radiation damage. Okay. Not too bad so far with the radiation. At a certain point, it won't even matter. But I think, yeah, maybe I'll have two or three building episodes within this Let's Play, and then maybe once it's done, I'll do some building episodes. I don't want to do too much building. Maybe I'll hop onto my other profile to do some building Let's Plays, but who knows? I think that's going to wrap it up for Sanctuary. I think I've explored all the houses. There may be this one over here. But no, I think I looked in these. I already looked in these. So that is going to do it for this episode, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. In the next one, we will talk to Codsworth, and we will continue the main story. So I hope you all enjoyed, and I'll catch you guys then. Peace out.